So, please tell us about that.
You will be surprised that till the 7th grade, I never used to go in school regularly. Means the teachers used to come and fetch me from my house. In the sense, I was so naughty that I will refuse to go and attend the school.
Shekhar, that reminds me, this
This used
used
to
to
happen
happen only in Maharaja's time. You know, teacher used to come home and teach, you
No,
know, so
no,
when he called you.
don't get me wrong. They used to come to, take me, two guys will hold my legs and two guys hold my hands and drag me to the school.
Chandrasekhar Maharaj, that is what we will call him.
I had an accident during Diwali. I had firecrackers in my pocket. I was doing experiment that time. If you remember those, small mirchi, lavangi mirchi, those firecrackers, if you loosen them and fire, it won't burst. It will go here and there. So I was playing with that. And in one pipe, I used to put it here and then I will aim it and it will go. And after 5-10 minutes, I don't know what happened. It went into my pocket where I kept all my crackers and it bursted like anything. And then I was on bed for almost 6 months naked. And that changed my life. And from that incident, from 8th standard, I started attending school, first bench. I never left from that day, even today. Wherever I go, I will always go and try to sit on the first bench.
But firecracker is a bad incident, so to say. Did you have any forethought of becoming something in life? You know, people have, when they are in school, they have infatuations of so many things.
Sure, yeah.
Let me share mine. I wanted to be a bus conductor. That was a fantasy. You know, ringing a bell and doing a tick-tick and all sorts of. What was yours?
See, by the age of, I was, I think, in 8th or 9th standard. That time, I'm forgetting the name. The Jayant Narulkar got an award for Nobel Prize, one of his inventions. And he was all over news and Maratha paper and
Yes.
all that stuff. That time it was black and white TV. And I was so fascinated with his inventions and stories and all that stuff. And that time I decided that I want to become a scientist, and that too a scientist who will get a Nobel Prize.
Fantastic.
Even today, if anybody asks me, I always say I want to get a Nobel Prize. And in fact, I'm working on that. I am still wandering into different areas, though. I have not focused on one area. I know that. But my idols are Newton. Now, the difference between Einstein and Newton is Einstein was lucky enough. He was, in fact, in a patent office, where he used to get a lot of patent applications, and he could read and he understands. Whereas during the time of Newton, there was nothing like publishing papers or any kind of stuff. In fact, he's the pioneer scientist who invented the optics, the calculus, the gravity and all that stuff. And incidentally, it was during the plague. Just like this time, we are locked down. During the plague also, everybody was locked down in the house, and he was locked down for a month in his home. And that time he has invented all these theories. He has written a book. Of course, it took him almost 10 years to publish it, but during that time he came up with all those inventions.
I wonder any optometrist has won Nobel till date. I'll certainly search on Google, but I do not recollect any optometrist specifically having a Nobel Prize, and we would certainly look forward to you.
Thank you.
Being the first Nobel Prize winner amongst all optometrists for that originality and research and something which will help the mankind.
Sure.
I'm very sure. I'm about to come to that, but not now.
Thank you.
You are cutting edge research on myopia, but that will keep for later part of our discussion. I was curious, if you were so different in schools and that, how did you come to this obscure subject called optometry? I'm sure optometry as a word is still not known all over the world, especially in India, and people ask us, optometrist means what? And during those days, I think it must have been 81, 82 when you joined.
Yes.
And had to in a place called Kumatipura, famously. Please tell us, how did you venture into optometry?
Yeah, the story starts with my uncle, S.B. Chauhan, who was...
doctor.
Yes, he was a pioneer in starting eye bank at J.J. Eye Hospital. JJ Hospital.
Sure.
And my brother was so influenced with him, so he joined the first batch of optometry when Dr. Sate started in Kamatipura.
Oh.
Rajan, my elder brother. And he forced me to join optometry. I said, no way, I want to become a computer scientist. I was doing my BSc in Bhavans College that time. So he forced me, no, you have to do this. So I was in first year BSc. And he took me to give interview. Dr. Sate asked me, why you want to join optometry? I said, my brother is asking me to join it here. So what are you doing now? I said, I'm doing my BSc. He said, okay, go get lost, do your BSc and then come. So next year again, whole 1 year, my brother, harassed me.
Pestered
you. Yes, and then next year again, I gave an interview. And that time Dr. Sate, oh, you are here again. I said, yes, I want to do optometry. So, okay, admission given. And that's how I used to do BSc. I used to attend practicals there because Bhavans College was just 15 minutes from Kamatipura Eye Hospital. And then I used to come here and attend Italia's lectures. And then again, after lunch, once we finished the lectures, I used to go back to college. That's how I started. I did both, and of course I continued my BSc physics. Since it was physics, the optometry is almost 80% physics only, so I was good here. And Dr. Vipin Tanna was AMO here at Kamatipura, and he know that I'm doing this BSc also, so he allowed me to do, and he encouraged me. In fact, he said, okay, Chandrasekhar, you do it. And continue this way. So I used to go back and forth, and even in college I got after I finished my BSc, I joined masters in Wilson College, but I got a chance to become a professor in Bhavans College again, because that time there was a shortage of teachers. So I continued as a professor, my education in BSc, masters and PhD, continuing my optometry at the same time. Thanks to my brother's force and Dr. Tanna, who helped me, encouraged me. And that time not many people used to do contact lenses, and I was the only person who invested into a trial set. I still remember I used to have that PMMA trial set of 24 lenses, and I used to fit contact lenses. Even all the doctors, Dr. Nitin Dedia, Balkrishna, Arif, Irfan, all those people, when they started their practice, they used to borrow my trial set to fit contact lenses. So, that is an encouragement, in fact. That time I used to stay, my family used to stay in Dadar. And by the time I was in fourth year, in my internship, my family shifted. They sold out that house from there to Dombili, and I moved my residence in Kamatipura Eye Hospital. I used to stay with these all doctors in guest rooms, and I used to study with these people, because in the evening, in the night, they used to study for master's exam. You know, they will pick up Duke Elder 1, I will pick up Duke Elder 2 and start reading with them. And that's how I could learn more in depth into, ophthalmology. In fact, I used to help them, attend the OT, attend the OPDs. It was fun. Those were golden times.
So
you were there. You also know.
You did. You learned physics in different college, ophthalmology in different college, contact lens. As a, you were doing say 12 hours, 15 hours a day.
Almost.
Was that the schedule?
Yeah, I would like to add one more thing that I was so fortunate. One Dr. Nitin Kakka, who was fiancé of Dr. Trivedi, Dwarika Trivedi, she was, after Vipin Tanna, she was the HMO, and I got introduced because of her, and he was the lecturer in JJ Hospital. So every Wednesday, I will go to JJ Hospital and attend all his emergency surgeries. I have attended except heart surgery and gynec surgeries. All surgeries. I have assisted him on all surgeries. So my general surgical knowledge also improved because of Dr. Kakka.
I would not. I would. If I had the facility, I would delete this part because I would not encourage people to venture into such things. But it was a beautiful knowledge. I accept that. Learning.
I am training you is the how I got this. Yes.
That is the idea of whole body, because I remember in our times, general anatomy as a subject was not taught, which is fortunately taught to all the undergraduates of optometry all over India right now. Coming back to optometry, once you graduated, you did your internship. What motivated you to stick back in optometry rather than venture into a need-laden path of BSc physics, MSc physics, PhD into physics? You did not mention that, but I know that you have done your PhD in physics. And if you were doing that, what made you stick into optometry? Was it your clinical knowledge? What is the love for the patient that you can take care of their... What was that? What made you stick back into optometry?
Incidentally, it's the money. What happened is...
very frank, thank
when,
you.
Yeah, see. What happened is, when I continued my optometry, my brother, within 1 year, he said, Chandrasekhar, there is a vacancy in Shirodkar opticians. Incidentally, he was also working with Naresh Shirodkar, who has 5-6 branches, and he opened another branch in Andheri, and he was looking for an optometrist. You know, that time even optometrists were very, scared.
Yeah.
It was not easily available. So he said, why don't you do a job? Because I was feeling shy to ask money, pocket money from my parents. So I said, hey, this is a good opportunity. I said, but I don't know how to do. He said, okay, no problem. You come to my, optical shop for 1 week and I'll show you what to do. So he showed me, we used to get those double mirror, convex and concave mirror, retinoscopes. And he taught me, see, this is how the glow you have to look for. Positive, negative, neutralize, and I'm an optometrist into Shirodkar Eye Hospital, new Shirodkar opticians in Andheri branch. My salary was 600 rupees, first class pass, and Naresh Shirodkar, mentored me on how to dress up, how to talk, how to behave. That were my, MBA lectures, kind of. He said, hey, you can't wear chappals, you have to wear shoes. you have to wear jackets, you have to wear tie, you have to wear, you know, spectacles to look, because that time I was single pasli and you know it was so he said you have
I
to look
remember
good to
you,
be
lanky,
present
tall,
everyone. Yes,
and intense young man.
yes
You were 1 year in my senior batch.
Yes.
And
so,
your class used to end and our class used to start.
Right.
So, but good that you told us. This also brings another important aspect of optometry, that optometry is a really paying branch right from the start.
See, another thing I would like to add here, Ajit, is though I was doing my professorgiri in college, you know, I was a professor of physics.
Yes.
But my salary was 1200 rupees and 1800 rupees, means 1200 rupees basic salary and DA, all that thing, I'll get home 1800 rupees. Whereas in my optical job, in 2 hours, I used to earn 5000, 6000, 10000 rupees that time. So why should I leave? And of course, you get to talk with patients, you get to interact with so many people, you know, it's a different lifestyle there.
Shekhar, let me interrupt you. There is an interesting question. The person says not to mention the name. And the question is, you were going into Bhavan's College and for MSc into Wilson's College and all that. And the person wants to know, what were your love stories?
we are public here. Anyway, my love story is my wife now. She's Smita, and during that time she used to accompany me. She used to come. All my college friends know her, and even during my Bombay Hospital times, we used to have lunch together in the Bombay Hospital mess, and then she will go to her college. She was studying in SNDT that time, and of course,
so
eventually,
probably he is someone who knows you.
Yes.
And that's why there is a pop-up question from that person.
Yes. And I'm thankful to her. She knows all my secrets, she knows all my girlfriends, she knows all my, you know, naughty things. So I'm thankful.
You are so fortunate. You
yes.
are so fortunate
yes.
to have
such a wonderful
Smita Thai as understanding wife.
Yes.
I know from all the history that she has supported you in all good and bad, all ups and downs in life. On this day of Vata Purnima, I salute her for all the difficulties that she has. After you started practice, so to say, you were set, you know, in a middle class family style, that you were a teacher, you had a job and all those things, and still you ventured outside. So, what made you take that decision? That because that is a hard decision to take, I understand. Leaving a security of a job and assured money, you went out.
See,
so, can you tell us about that?
As I said, I was staying in Municipal Eye Hospital guest rooms. And Dr. Nitin Dedia was my, you know, of course he was one of the resident that time. His father's clinic was empty because he was no more, and it was a ENT practice in Grant Road. And he said, hey, you finished your optometry and I have this clinic if you want to practice. I said, that's a wonderful job, a wonderful offer. So I used to pay him some nominal rent, and I started that clinic. I used to sit there in the evenings, and I was referring all my patients from Bombay Hospital to that clinic. So Bombay Hospital is like a paid job, 1200 rupees a month, but I used to spend I think more than 2000 rupees on a petrol to reach and travel. but I started two practices, one in Ajinkya Polyclinic in Girgaon, and this Bombay Cycle on the top floor of that Bombay Mercantile Bank in Grant Road. And that's how I started my private practice. Though I am an optometrist, I was having my own optometry practice. So where I used to fit contact lenses, I used to do low vision, I used to do vision therapy, everything that time. And I used to charge 100 rupees as a consulting fee that time. You won't believe, you know, that was it. That time it was very, expensive thing. But, Dr. Nitin Dedia encouraged me. And then once he completed his master's after 2 years, he said, Chandrasekhar, now I want my place back. By then, all my practice built up goes to him and I'm searching another practice. But anyway, that gave me a lot of confidence. And I always, since then, I always entered into my own practice. Of course, I used to practice in the evening in Sarfare Arogya Kendra in Parel, because that was giving me a fixed salary. Bombay Hospital, you know, even 1200 rupees fixed salary. The professor job, it was small amount, but you know, that gave me freedom.
So what did you, what made you go out of India?
Well, it's an interesting story. Before going there, I would like to mention Dr. B.T. Maskati and Dr. Kuresh Maskati. Dr. Kuresh started doing intraorbital implants in India first time. And after doing such an expensive surgery, there was no one who can give a custom-made prosthesis. So he said, and he knew me since my Kamatipura days, because I am a good artist also. I spent 5 years in JJ School of Arts also, side by side Bombay Hospital. So he knew that I am a good artist. So he encouraged me to go to Moorfields Eye Hospital, London, and learn this art of ocularistry. And there is no college, even today there is no college, no curriculum to teach you ocularistry. It was difficult, but thanks to Dr. B.T. Maskati, I could go into Moorfields Eye Hospital, London. And after coming back from there, I was experimenting with different materials. Since I was already into contact lenses, I was fascinated to use soft contact lens material to make a prosthesis, because that time one patient had a corneal ulcer, like a nevus kind of thing, and she wanted some non-sensitive, comfortable prosthesis, and I was struggling with that. And that time I started learning how to make resins or how to make polymers, how to make hydrogel materials. And one of my friend was doing PhD in UDCT in Wadala. So his lab was open for me. I used to go and sit with him. With his iCard, I used to attend the library and read all the literatures. And I started making my own polymers. And I made the first soft custom-made artificial eye. I presented it in various platforms. Yes. And I got an invitation from Argentina to give a talk or presentation in Argentina.
Fantastic.
So that's how I thought, okay, somebody's asking me to give lecture, so why not go there? Ultimately, they promised me that they'll give me air ticket and everything, but at the last moment, like 1 week before, they said, we can't give you air ticket. But by then, I have planned all my journey through USA, and I was supposed to attend one...
Bothered you that some element of failure might touch, because research, anything can happen, I can understand that. So, how would you guide people watching all over that, how should they take this up?
See, as a man of science, what I learned in college is how to learn and how to do experiments. If you remember the famous story of Edison, after making 1,000 bulbs, he could make a final bulb. So he never gave up. And thankfully, Dr. Maskati, as I said, B.T. Maskati, every Wednesday I will meet him in Mulund. And he will ask me, Chandrasekhar, he will call me Chavan. Chavan, what's new? So I had to come up with some new idea.
Yes.
And that, you know, became a habit of thinking new, experimenting. I spend a lot of money. Even today, whatever I earn, 50% of that money goes to research. Even today. Okay. So the research is a part of development. Once you start doing all that, you get a hang of it. You enjoy yeah. that, you know. I would like to tell you one story here.
You have put a hand on a very live wire. Research and money spent on research is something which very few Indian companies of a great repute do not do. And thanks to your science teachings and probably Western thought and staying there, this germ of research you could pursue and continue. Probably your PhD and research also helped in that. With that, I would like to ask, you ventured into manufacturing of contact lenses. From prosthesis,
yes.
You also venture into manufacturing of contact lenses. Please elaborate on that also.
Yeah. So, actually, I'll just take you a little back. You know, when I was teaching and training Kuldeep and Deepa in LV Prasad, there was one Dr. M.S. Sridhar, who was a corneal surgeon. He expired a few years back, quite young age, very dynamic person. And that time I used to go to him and show him that, hey, I have developed this keratoprosthesis. You know, with working with Dr. Kuresh Maskati, there was one Italian surgeon, Pintucci. And he has a fantastic keratoprosthesis. Boston keratoprosthesis is very famous, but Pintucci keratoprosthesis is more long-lasting. It looks ugly, but it is good for...
He wears a very colorful surgery cap.
Yeah, so he also expired, yes, but I had an opportunity to spend time with him in Sri Lanka, India and all. So I have developed my own keratoprosthesis. So I was showing this to Dr. Sridhar. He said, Chavan, I am not interested in this. I am interested in scleral lenses. I said, what scleral lenses? He said, you know, scleral shell, we want optics in that because that can give vision to blind. See, right now you are giving cosmesis by putting a prosthesis. Of course, that changes the life of a person. Everything is good. But imagine giving a vision back to someone. And he said, if you can do that, it will be great. So I started doing my research. Again, go back to research. I started doing my research. Who is doing scleral lenses? Only two people on earth that time. Don Ezekiel from Australia and Perry Rosenthal in USA. I could get connection with Don Ezekiel thanks to Ashok Pradhan, who was owner of FlexiLens.
Yes.
And he put me in touch with Don Ezekiel. Don Ezekiel happily gave me all his presentations, papers, everything. I learned from him that, and then I wanted to make a scleral lens. But that time, Polymer Technology, who makes the button, which you people know as a Boston, Bosch and Lomb. So the main lab is Polymer Technology. So they refused. They said, we make only large buttons for Perry Rosenthal. We don't sell it. We can give you 14mm buttons. That is a small contact lens button. I said, no, I want big. They will say no. So then with my, you know, learning and understanding and experimenting with my polymers, with, you know, UDCT, I made my own buttons. I bought one small lathe from Ashok Pradhan, and I cut my own lenses. I made a fenestrated scleral lenses, a 55 lens trial set, and Dr. Srinivas from SKR, from Shankar Netralaya, he invited me to see patients and give lecture. Even Dr. Badrinath came for that lecture. It is very honorable and, you know, prestigious to give lecture in Shankar Netralaya. And, you know, that time I had fitted only 12 eyes, but fantastic, you know, it's a so much comfort, great recovery of vision. Then I went to different hospitals and fitted almost more than 55-60 keratoconus patients with this fenestrated scleral lens. And one of the patient told me that why don't you go to USA, Perry Rosenthal. He is doing non-fenestrated lenses. And during one of the conferences also, I came across few corneal surgeons from Boston. They also said you must go to Perry Rosenthal. And that's how I started communicating with Perry Rosenthal. If you have a time, I can share you one story. See, all this thing happening in my life is not me doing. It's someone superior up there who's doing it, you know. Because my life has changed overnights. So what happened is I was going back to my USA practice. I decided to start my own practice in a place called Denver. So I was carrying 70 kg of my equipment, material, everything. And I landed in New York, and there was my schedule was little. I went there 3 days before my schedule to Denver. So 3 days, what we'll do? So one day I roam around New York. Second day I said, what to do? Let us go to Boston because it is only 3 hours. 5 hours from New York. So I took a bus, night bus, went to Perry Rosenthal. I have written to him 6 months back that I want to meet you. And here I go, Indian, you just go, oh, I happen to be here. I just want to say hi. But he's just a, you know, gem of a person. I give my card to the reception and says, I have communicated with him and I want to meet Perry. That time there I said, I am coming from India. This, oh, you came all the way from India to meet Perry. So she gave card inside. Perry came out with her within fraction of seconds. Oh, fantastic. Chandra, come. He took me inside. And there I go. I go with him. He sees all the patients. And then during lunchtime, then he asks me, hey, what happened? This, that. Then I show him my keratoprosthesis. I show my fenestrated scleral lens. He falls in love. Hey, you already know scleral lenses. So it's wonderful. So second day, I had only one day. So second day, I said, hey, I want to learn. I want to spend more time with you. But unfortunately, I have a ticket to go back to Denver, because that is my, you know, destiny. I have to start my own clinic. So one of his partner, Mark Cohen, I call him Laughing Buddha. Whatever I ask him, he'll give me. So he said, Chandra, why don't you join us as a, you know, a fellow? I said, I don't have money to give you fellowship fees. He said, no, we'll take care of you, everything. So he offered me a fellowship. He, you know, put me in a hotel. He put me in one of the director's lavish bungalow, gave me $300. He will come in the morning, pick me up in his car, take me to the Boston site, that is our Boston Foundation for Sight, see the patients with Perry Rosenthal. In the evening, he'll take me to dinner. I have seen all restaurants. Every evening, he'll take me to different restaurant in Boston. And it was a royal treatment. It was, I really enjoyed those times. And then they put me as a director for clinical operations, and they thought I'm the next to Perry, you know. That's how they treated me. They put me on a salary, they put me as a director, and you know, it's a wonderful time that time.
Very interesting story, and life takes you from one end of the globe to the other.
Yeah.
From Australia to US and whatnot. Doing all those things, you probably lost your money in research and you regained with whatever practice you made, and then you went to US and you came back and you wanted to put that money in India and this and that. Frankly speaking, it doesn't suit the typical middle class Indian mentality, where I would like to preserve everything which I got and spend a little here and there, and you know, enjoy a goody life.
Well,
but
see, my family background was never a job oriented thing. We are from a royal family, but when we started, we came back to, I will not tell you all the story. But when we came back to Dadar, by the time I, started knowing all what is what, and I wanted to make my own money, my father was an engineer, and we used to have this sewing machine shop. He is the one who invented a link model for Usha company, if you know Usha. It's a very famous brand in India. He started his own manufacturing called Viki sewing machine. We used to have a shop opposite Shiv Sena Bhavan. As a child, I used to play with Raj Thackeray and Uddhav Thackeray. I used to spend time with Shirish Pai, you know, Acharya Atre. And my mother is a kirtankar. She is a Habapa. She has a degree of Habapa, Hari Bhakta Parayan. It's a 4 years course, and she is a she will give, you know, kirtan. So all that, you know, into me, that you have brought nothing in this world, you know, so there is nothing to lose. So, you know, whatever I have, I had nothing. So even if I make too much money or too much thing, ultimately it is going to go west. What is going to remain on this earth is my name, my deeds, whether I did good or bad. People are going to remember me, you know, not because you don't know how much money I have in my pocket, but you know me, how I treat you, how I talk to you, whether I helped you in your life. See, when I started my Shekhar Eye research after leaving Boston Foundation, you know, whatever patients comes to my clinic, my costs are very high because of my research, and you know, most of our materials, raw materials come from US, this, that. I will not refuse any patients on the grounds of money. So you have to sometimes make, you know, losses, but I will still do that to help that patient, and that satisfaction of that patient, that blessings, that is what is still helping me to live a normal and peaceful life. And still I am hoping and coming out with lot of new technologies, new research, and lot of new stuff.
Okay. Shekhar, we are around 48 minutes of chat.
I know.
And I really want to ask you two questions before we close down in, say, 2 minutes time.
Sure.
One is that there is a lot of research going on myopia control.
Right.
And we have heard your talks on various platforms and even live. And people are really wanting to, you know, there are few people who are in it and there are few people who are out of it. They still believe that this myopia pandemic, you know, people have now known the word pandemic because of corona, and people still believe that myopia is not a pandemic and it is just a hype made by a few people who want to, you know, do certain things. The research, they do not read the research, not atom and atom through studies and, you know, something like that. And so I want to ask you, in a nutshell, can you be specific in saying why there is a fear of myopia, and specifically what is your research as optometrist taking you to conquer this pandemic?
See, if you see any Chinese news, nowadays there are a lot of Chinese news. All those people, including military and army, are wearing glasses. Okay, so we call it epidemic, not pandemic. It's an epidemic of myopia. There is a difference between two.
Yes.
So we have learned, see, 1/3 of the population lives in China, 1/3 of population of the world lives in India, and rest of the 1/3 is divided into USA and all that stuff. So we have a huge population. Okay, why Modi ji suddenly took this decision and, you know, put down this country in lockdown? We learn from different countries. What is happening in China? What is happening in USA? What is happening in Europe? Okay, so we are learning from these people that myopia epidemic is there. Whether you realize it, whereas you accept it or not. You know, if you don't, you know, keep your eyes closed, it doesn't mean that there is not happening. if you are in an urban situation, you go to any school, 30% of children are wearing glasses. So what is that? It is epidemic of myopia. Okay, you will say, okay, when my child will grow at 20, he will do LASIK surgery. No, even if after doing LASIK surgery, the damage which is caused on the stretch of the eyeball is going to put him into retinal problems, you know, retinal detachment, glaucoma, cataracts. And at the age of 50, 60, he is going to have fear of losing vision. And to do that, you have to start act now. So these children's has to be, you know, looked upon and cared for with myopia control technologies today to secure our future. See, we have done, right? I don't have any glasses,
right,
but my children's may have, you know, of course, luckily, Shriya don't have anything, but, you know, it's a lifestyle. And we are soon going to be there. So learn from others. That is what research again. What is research? You have to learn from what other people have done. Okay, you can't invent, you can't come up with anything new. You have to learn, you have to build up your story from what two, three people have done. You come up with something new idea, form a hypothesis and try to prove it. You may prove, you may disapprove, you know, you say fail, it's okay, but you go ahead, that's how. So after learning that, I have attended so many conferences, thanks to Nitesh Barot, you know, Kerry, you know, yeah. Matthew Hesberg, you know, variety of people, they help me, they encourage me, you know, whenever I will go in the conferences, I'll get a chance to interact one-to-one with this. See, I invest money into my education. I spend, to go to USA and attend one conference, it takes 4-5 lakhs rupees, okay. So, but I never, you know, looked back. I said, no, I will recover. And that's why I, ultimately what I learn, who's going to benefit, my patients are going to benefit from that. So they pay for that. At the same time, I don't refuse patients. That is okay. Another thing.
Coming back to research, you have done two fantastic things, as I know. One is that you have invented spectacle lens, which can be fitted for, my real myopia control, where you control the peripheral defocus.
Yes.
It would be wonderful for us to know the things about your research and how it is going to be beneficial to the community.
So what happened is I started with orthokeratology for myopia control, which is very expensive, 50,000, 60,000, 1 lakh, you know, it's a very expensive device, so everybody cannot afford that. A soft contact lens, multifocal soft contact lens I made, which is little relatively cheaper, but Indian people, as you said, they are afraid, oh, no, you know, I'll not put contact lens in my child's eye. So that's where I realized that there has to be something which is easy, and so that people won't get scared, and it should work on it. Incidentally, USFDA also approved one of the spectacle for myopia control in the US.
Yes.
And I was closely working on those, thanks to my, you know, PhD in optics. I know about aberrations and, you know, chromatic aberrations and all that stuff. So I came up with a spectacle glass which has a optical aberration as well as a chromatic aberration to get this myopic defocus on the peripheral retina. There is a wonderful paper I came across last week only, which they have proven within 2 hours even the shape of the retina can change. I can share you those papers on our myopia control group.
Fantastic.
I have shared that. So within 2 hours it can change. The eyeball can accommodate to those peripheral signals. And this spectacle glass that I have come up with is amazing. It's going to help so many children because it's cheap. It is easy. Anyway, the child is going to wear spectacles. Only he has to upgrade it to myopia control spectacles. You know, I call it Myo Vision Arc glasses. And incidentally, there is one step ahead of all the world, which again I can proudly say, I control astigmatism also on the same principle. Most of the kids nowadays have astigmatism, myopic astigmatism. So I do those aberrations on the axis which is against to that, and I create same principle is same. You come up with those, you know, myopic defocuses by whatever means you can, and it works.
Shukran, you are a wonderful person. you have explained the difficult things in such a simple, lucid language. You know, I fear that if you make it more simpler, even a person like me would think that I can do it.
Yes, you can do it. It's easy. See, the whole idea is even the optician should be able to offer this to their patients, you know. And nowadays all opticians has optometrists there who can take all the measurements for him.
Yes. Shekhar, with all these things in mind, going from one research over to the other and listening to so many things, I think you must be sort of, you know, bombarded with optometry, and your wife and your dear kid must be saying that we do not even see Shekhar as my husband or my father. And I see there is one sitar sitting next to you, and you said that you are a painter, you are a sculptor. What besides optometry? What we know Shekhar as optometrist, as inventor, as manufacturer of contact lens, as manufacturer of something beyond, you know, from corneal to mini sclerals to sclerals to whatnot, from routine prosthesis to a soft frill prosthesis which patient was very happy to wear. What else? How many hours you have in your day, and what else have you done in life?
Well, you know, in nutshell, as you said, you know, I brought four technologies in India: scleral lenses, artificial eyes, orthokeratology, and myopia control. But to get to do all this research, your mind has to be happy, and you know, it has to have the energy. My energy is my Smita and Shriya. So whenever I get chance, I will attend some musical programs, some, you know, movies. My daughter is into film now. She's a film director. She did one film for Netflix also. So you know, we have a diverse background. As you know, I do special effect lenses for film industry, Shah Rukh Khan, you know, Hrithik Roshan, and all these big people. So that is my enjoyment. I spend time, you know, listening to music. I have so many friends who are singers. They will, on one call, they will come to my house. We'll have a mahfil. If you attend, you know, I attend this music. I make this organize this music for vision program during my conference, Super Speciality Lens Symposium, because I am an artist at heart. You know, I enjoy painting, sculpting, my making artificial eyes. What? It's a sculpting only. So you know,
I do know
using
that
that energy,
old house,
yes,
had a studio-like arrangement where super quality music would be, you know, played and listened to, and just a thought. Do you yourself play music or sing? Do you?
I sing. I started learning fluet from one of my college friend, Apurva Srivastava, who is in USA now. His father was Raghunath Seth. If you see all the old documentaries, all documentaries, music director is Raghunath Seth. So he is a very famous fluet artist. So I started learning, but I could not learn too much because you have to, you know, ganda and all that stuff. So I could not do. I am still a free man, you know. I venture into so many different things, you know. So even today I am into, you know, space travel. I am into, you know, research. I have my own research for pollution control and all that sort of stuff. But the music is one which connects you to that higher, superior, you know, whatever you call it. My book is coming called Chandrasekhar's Theory of Fifth Dimension, where I am trying to explain my superior energy in a scientific manner. See, we believe in God, but the God, G-O-D, and the, our God is different. So that is what I am trying to explain into that. But I sing, of course, not as a professional, but yes, I can definitely sing.
I'll cut you short. because you mentioned about God and the superior power, let me ask you a question. If the Almighty gave you superior powers, you know, I'll just quote a narration. When we were in school, we were asked, if I was to become a prime minister, or if I was to become a god, what would I do to this mankind, society, earth? So, if such powers were vested upon you, what would you do for optometry? Where would you see optometry going? What is your vision of ideal optometry to be in India?
Well, see, I don't regret whatever God has been given. I think I'm the chosen one. He has been kind enough to, you know, use me as his medium and do whatever. Because it is not, I can't do anything. It is some supernatural power who has to work through you. And as far as optometry is concerned, I will say all the optometrists, you are the first point of contact as an eye care practitioners. Okay, so just stop, don't stop there. You learn, you develop, because I can compare optometry in India and in US, there is a lot of thing that we should study, we should learn, and nobody can stop you from learning. You don't have to go to college to learn. You know, you look at my example. Nobody could stop me from learning, right? So you can also learn. Don't blame your college or school that, oh, they never taught me. You just now you said we never had anatomy properly, right? But I still remember Dr. Sheila Tanna teaching me anatomy. Dr. Dhage from Sangli used to teach me anatomy. So you could learn whatever way, Karad, yes. So it is up to you. So all the optometrists in India should try and learn. See, we are a minus surgeon, right? We are a physician, actually. Though it doesn't, of course, the rules are coming up, our colleges will, you know, get, and then afterwards I given all 9 different JMIs and all this stuff. But they twisted it. So people got angry. Who is he to put, you know, diamond things into eye and this and that? So they created a controversy. It was going on for almost 1 week. You know, news channels will interview me, newspapers will interview me, and this and that. And ultimately, the Devasthan Trust, they said, see, whoever can donate anything to us, it is we decide whether to put it in, you know, in the box or put it on the goddess. On the goddess. Yeah. And we thought this is the best thing. So, you know, we are putting it. See, today there are so many deities and people donate gold and diamond and a lot of stuff. Why not to my deity? She is my mother, you know, she is mother of whole world. So nothing wrong in that. Let them enjoy. I'm enjoying my, in fact, they made me famous, I would say, you know, because you have to have some controversy, no? Otherwise, who will remember or talk about you?
wonderful. I know that we can go on and on and talk about many more aspects of Chandrasekhar Chavan here, but today it's the time to, you know, close this chit-chat. And before I close, I really wish to thank you for giving different aspects of thinking about life, thinking about optometry, how to practice, how to invent, how to look at it, how to be the best, and all sorts of things. I wish many more optometrists in India and all over the world listen to this and make best use of this thought, put that in their nature, research ahead, go to the root, do their best, and become better optometrists than what they are. Chandrasekhar, you have done wonderful things in life. And all fraternity of optometry, I wish you luck. Be with us, invent so many things, teach us, we will make this earth better, more having more vision more life to their eyes. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ajit. Thank you. Wonderful talking to you.
With that, I just wanted to say hi. We said coffee with this. When there was, I was talking to my friends, and one of my friends who actually brings excellent coffee from Germany. I know you had gone to Germany, and this is his brand, Grandos, and wonderful coffee. And he has presented you with this mug as soon as the lockdown is over. He has gift packed another mug for you, and I will definitely come and hand over that golden coffee package and the mug for your taste. I know you love coffee, and you would love Grandos coffee as well.
Thank you, thank you.
With this, I would like to say that from next session onwards, it would be a fortnightly affair with fantastic optometrists like Shekhar. We would bring optometrists from all nooks and corners of India and Indian optometrists who are abroad for their informal chat and learning through them the nitty-gritties of becoming better and the best. So it would be 15 days from now. Till that, all of you, namaskar, stay home, stay safe, and fight COVID.